There are 2 years in my life, most recently, where I felt incredibly stuck. And incidentally, it was right after a really important milestone in my life. And well, today is a big milestone in my life. I'm doing the TED Talk. And I want to be able to share with you my experience of being stuck and then getting unstuck. And I hope that there'll be some takeaways today. In addition, I'd like to practice two things I learned from these two experiences. The first one, doing something uncomfortable. The second one is being vulnerable. You see, I grew up in a family and also my current profession where being vulnerable and doing something gutsy is not acknowledged. If anything, it's not part of the job description. But in being stuck, I had to figure things out. Being a child of two educators in an incredibly orthodox Catholic environment, and then being a professor of management, I really had to figure out what I personally felt was the way through being unstuck, because my winning formula was not giving me the intended outcomes. So, the milestone, the first one was, I had worked for many years, going to the best schools in the entire world. I had worked with colleagues across the world. I had a very successful life in academia. Not only was I successful as a professor, I was teaching all over the world. I was teaching students in Croatia, Dubrovnik, and Zagreb. And I was also teaching students in Dubai. I had created this portfolio of amazing experiences, not only for myself, but for my students. And yet in 2019, I find myself extremely stuck. I was unengaged, uninspired. My students felt the same. I could see it in their response to the way that I was teaching. I just felt like I couldn't move forward. Now, consider this. We spend a lot of our time not only creating goals, but working towards those goals. When we get to those goals and we accomplish them, we're so excited. We pat ourselves on the back. We tell everybody about our accomplishments. They give us their acknowledgement that we've reached those goals. But here I was feeling stuck and I felt anxious. I had put in over 20 years into my career and I was trying to figure out, do I retool? Do I go to corporate America? Do I go into not-for-profits? This anxiety was again keeping me stuck, but also creating an environment where I felt beaten down. So what did I do? I went to my dean and I just told her, I feel like I'm not being the best instructor I can. I need you to support me in my next journey. And she said, what's your next journey? I said, I want to go back to school. She's like, why? I said, because my students are two generations younger than me. I don't know what it's like to be in a classroom in the 21st century. I did not take an online course. I don't know what it's like to sit through 3 hours of Zoom courses. I need to go back so that I can have empathy for my students, but also brush up on my skills. And she supported me. So guess what I did? I enrolled in a master's program in my own department. I went back to school, I got an MBA from the very same colleagues I had the most incredible fear of looking uninformed, unintelligent, a novice. I was in classes where they were giving me grades. Believe me, I did not pass every class. And all during COVID. This gave me such incredible insight into what our students were going through. In fact, I was able to translate that experience into the creation of our program, we realized we were not serving our students. I was able to use that empathy for my students to advocate for more inclusive spaces. I decided to look further and collaborate with faculty outside of my college and created a wonderful course where we took students of color to Bosnia, Montenegro, and to Croatia. And then finally, I was asked, you know what, there's this great opportunity. It's not teaching, it's administration. What do you think? And because I had already taken that gutsy move and had been in that place where I was uncomfortable, I had that incredible knowledge of what it meant to be not only a learner in the 21st century, but had empathy for the experiences our students were. And I said, yes, I will definitely do this. So I said there were two experiences, right? The second one was unfortunately more personal. After 10 years of being married, I realized that my relationship had come to an end. I had worked so hard to do the right things, to choose the right person, to date for 2 years, to get married in a church, to have children in wedlock. And here I was, 10 years of trying to make it work. And what I held on to was the need for me to rediscover myself. So I did what every other lifelong learner does. I looked for things to learn. I went outside academia and decided to take black and white photography. I learned how to do my own prints, all in the need to figure out why there was this inertia in my life. And after the confidence of remembering who I was before I was married, I decided that I'm going to choose myself. I'm going to be responsible for my happiness, and I'm going to ask for a divorce. So from these two experiences, what can I offer to you? If you are feeling unstuck or feeling stuck, sorry, if you want to get unstuck, if there are people in your life who you feel are floundering, maybe you're in a relationship that is floundering, maybe you have work relationships that are not going in the direction that you want to do. First of all, don't blow things up immediately. Take a step back. Figure out why you're feeling stuck. Feeling stuck is the absence of growth. It's a place where we have decided that we are comfortable. Remember, there were two huge milestones. The first one was reaching the pinnacle of my career, and the second one was doing the right thing and starting a family. They say that it's the journey, not the destination. But they say, yes, the destination is important, but the person who started the destination at the beginning may have changed when they come to the final stop, right? That journey changes you. And if you're not paying attention to the changes, once you get to the destination, then what? We sit there, as I said, we tap ourselves on the back. We survey the heights at which we have reached, and we settle. I challenge you not to settle. As you continue on that journey to that destination, figure out the things that you had to do in order to get there. I assure you, you had to make some compromises. I'm pretty sure you'd had to change your attitudes. I'm pretty sure some of the core aspects of yourself will have changed. So when you get to that destination, you know the journey has changed you. So, second thing is, when you're feeling stuck in the absence of this growth, start by doing something small, learning something small, something that gives you joy. It might be even adjacent to the area in which you're feeling stuck. For me in my marriage, the first thing I did was to try and figure out other things that made me happy. In my career, I had to go straight into what in my career needed to be changed. So, small wins create confidence and clarity. And with that clarity, you can bring that to making changes to that area in which you're feeling stuck. So, If you right now in this space are taking this all in, learning all these amazing ideas from all of us, and you realize that you are feeling stuck in some aspect of your life, I challenge you to be uncomfortable, to take a risk, and let's see where that takes us. Thank you very much.